This is a raspberry hibiscus. They call it raspberry because that's, I think, the color is. If somebody has been using the wrong color, let me know. This is one of my hibiscus flowers in my hibiscus hedge. It has a lot of little coloring. I have given out many cuttings from this over the years. And just look at the color. I have another green one with this raspberry one. It's a little more prolific than some of the other hibiscus flowers in the garden hedge garden over here. So we'll just capture the moment over here before the rains come. Supposedly they are coming. And I'll just sit down here for a second just to capture the moment. And there we are. It's a raspberry hibiscus. It's on the lower end of the hedge, like 5 feet tall. This is the bottom end. And I looked up just to make sure we're not getting the lightning. You may hear something over the phone or over the video. As you get, there's the wind picking up. Something's just moving. So, getting near time to evacuate the premises, but we'll hang out there for another 30, 40 seconds just to capture the moment of my little raspberry hibiscus in the Doherty garden. Thank you for stopping by. We'll take us out. We have many hedges. One of the cool little hobbies that you can get down here in South Florida, because all you have to do is just walk around. You don't have to go to the garden center. Almost every development has some sort of hibiscus flower growing in their landscape. All you have to do is just snap off a little 2 to 3 inch section, take a little rooting medium or two. When you're capturing the cutting, just take a little napkin, wrap it up in a napkin with a little water dampen it, so this way it survives the trip home. Or if you have a plastic bag that you can put it in, with a little water and a little napkin, and that'll go well and good. But when you get home, just slice it at a 45 degree angle, apply some rooting medium to it, and put it in a little potting soil, and let Mother Nature out in sunny days take care of it for you. In a short period of time, you'll see new leaves emerging from the lower stem. And if you want, I guess, to make sure that it does grow, as you can snip off the flower just to take the strength away from the plant away from giving the strength of the flower. So your lower color, you just put the flower there up to it, and you'll just watch the hibiscus grow. And over a short period of time, it will start giving out new green shoots. Hence, you have successfully mastered the art of a hibiscus cutting. That's it. Molly, thank you for stopping by. It's time to get in. Weather is